JBTV is brought to you by GuitarCable.com. Hey, I'm Jerry Bryant. This is JBTV, nonstop music all this hour. Toby is in the studio with Strung Out as they perform live on our JBTV high definition soundstage. And then you got a dollar bill. You know, nowadays it's worth like, well, you know. Anyhow, a dollar bill may be burned on this edition of JBTV, and you're only going to find out if you wait to see Ryan Mano as he hangs out with David Costa. As David Costa lives, an exclusive performance on our JBTV High Definition Soundstage. And then Jenna and Nicole are at the rink with the Chicago Outfit Roller Derby. They are going to be trying out and hanging out with the ladies. This is a really good show. And then I'm hanging out with the one and only Drive A right here at JBTV. The year is 2000. The band is Disturbed. It's an exclusive old interview. You know, one of those archive segments. This is JBTV, so get your dollars out. Let's rock and roll all this hour, nonstop style. Are you ready?
It's JBTV. I'm Ryan Mano. Thrilled to be joined this week by my friends and David Costa. How are you?
Hi, Ryan.
My friend David Costa. We're
doing
well. It's always hard to figure out how to introduce you guys.
It is. That's been, a balance beam that we've teetered on.
It's a band.
It is.
We're going by like Lives now, right? Or something.
We're going by David Costa Lives right now.
I think we just worked that out.
All right, quick, get serious, quick.
I'm sorry to report while you slept there was an emergency. Your government has been hijacked by neoliberal, neoconservative one-party criminals. And now the plan is Pakistan, Afghanistan, Iraq, Iran. I am not a happy man. This is to the republic for which I stand. I put my left hand on the Bible and raise my right hand and say, to the Constitution of the United States. It's to you I am loyal, there's no two-sided face. And to the Bill of Rights, it's you I embrace. It's for you I will fight until it's my dying day. So while I'm running through the woods and dodging bullets, fucking warm in December. 3 years ago, I remember better days, but now it's raining fire. A third of the forest been to set ablaze. And now they telling me I need to put a chip on my ID so they can track my every move by radio frequency. If I don't comply, I run the risk of immediately inconveniencing all of the people being obedient. See, they say if you ain't with us, you against us. You best just go on ahead, fall in line with what the message presents. It's a consensus, but wait, let's just look at it closer. Stands to benefit the most from having a chip on your shoulder. And I say, to the Constitution of these United States, it's to you I am loyal, there's no two-sided face. And to the Bill of Rights, it's you I embrace. It is for you I will fight. Every corner I turn, I see another demon waiting where we formerly were. I'm in a world where nothing is ever as though it seems. I'm constantly under pressure. I got to be on my feet so I can walk through the valley called the shadow of death and talk to the badly lost despite our shadow of death. So I can walk through the valley called the shadow of death and talk to the badly lost and tell them good morning, America. There is a sense of urgency. I'm sorry to report what you said there was an emergency. Your government has been hijacked by neoliberal, neoconservative, one-party criminals. The criminal. And not a plan is Pakistan, Afghanistan, Iraq, Iran. I am not a happy man. This is to the republic for which I stand. Put my left hand on the Bible and raise my right hand and say to the Constitution. Constitution of these United States. It's to you I am loyal, no two-sided face. And to the Bill of Rights, you know it's you I embrace. And it is for you I will fight
till it's my dying day.
This is to the Constitution of these United States. It's to you I am loyal, there's no two-sided face. And to the Bill of Rights, you know it's you I embrace. It's for you I will fight
until it's my dying day.
So I can walk through the valley called the shadow of death, and talk to the badly lost despite our shadow of death. So I can walk through the valley called the shadow of death, and talk to the badly lost, and tell them this is still America, and you still have time. You can speak your mind, it's not against the law yet, but we've been sleeping for a long time. Put to sleep by the lullabies of lies. Good morning, America.
Good morning, America.
Time to wake up.
Get off that NyQuil.
I think it was 2009. When you guys were here, you made your debut on the JBTV HD soundstage right here, and now you're back. A lot's changed. It's a lot prettier. We've gotten on a new network. And, you know, things have happened for both of us. But do you, any of you, have any recollection, any special memories of the time you played here?
If I'm not mistaken, it was kind of an experiment.
It was.
It was like the first time it was streaming, I think.
Yeah.
I could be wrong.
No, yeah, we streamed
it.
We streamed it on the web.
And
it was the first show that I did here with Jerry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, and your brother was here as well.
Right, yeah, Kevin was here.
We brought in the Love Hammers.
Right.
Or you did.
Yep.
I can't take credit for that. And the Fold was there as well.
It was the first crowd time too, right?
It was the first time we'd really ever packed
brought
in a crowd.
Brought a crowd in.
Yeah.
That was awesome.
It was our first time playing on television too.
This is David Costa Lives, our guest this week. They're performing live on the JBTV HD soundstage. Don't go anywhere.
Still to come on JBTV, Strung Out is performing live, plus Drive A is in the studio. It's all here next. JBTV!
Well, hi, I'm Tobias Chegg with JBTV. I'm here with the men of Strung Out, correct? I would ask for an introduction, but these guys really need no introduction, right? You know? Why don't you introduce yourself? I know we got Jason over here. Come on.
You just did.
Yeah, all right. There you go.
They betrayed, set down the setting sun and the silence. Planting trees with everyone. Well,
in the sun, wasting away.
The last time I saw the members of Strung Out, it was in Atlanta, if I'm not mistaken. Jason, that was you, correct?
Yes.
What was the circumstances of our meeting in Atlanta?
What was the name of that strip club? The what?
Yeah, it's called the Claremont Lounge.
The Claremont Lounge.
It's one of the most famous skin bars in all of the country, I would say. And, like, not that we, of course, endorse the objectification of women in any way.
But that wasn't like that.
It was not like that at all.
No, it wasn't.
I don't even think.
Like one leg there.
There's a lot of one-legged stuff, yeah. But I definitely think we had a good time. We couldn't see anything anyhow, pretty much, by the end of. We were kind of blind drunk.
Yeah. Blotto.
Blotto.
Yes. I just got knighted that night.
You got knighted?
Uh-huh.
That's pretty cool.
That was what I was celebrating at the Claremont.
Who knighted you?
Medieval Times.
Oh, you got knighted in Medieval Times? Yeah. That's pretty cool. We'll get to Medieval Times later.
This is JBTV. In the studio, we have Drive A, plus David, Costa Lives, performs live. It's all here next on JBTV. Our 26th year of bringing you great bands and a lot more in the studio, Drive A.
Give us some background, how you got started and everything.
We started the band about 4 years ago, and then we met our drummer Cody from a mutual friend, and then on one of our earliest tours, we had another friend of ours fill in on a bass. And then we were looking for a permanent member, and he sent us a video, actually, because he's from Milwaukee and the rest of us are from LA. So he sent us a video, and then we saw him, we flew him out, and then it's been a few years since. So.
Wow. Well, I love your sound. You guys are just perfect,
thank
you know.
You.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Have you done a lot of television stuff? Or?
Not really. Uh-huh. Not.
Is this
not
like your first official TV thing?
It might be, yeah.
Hey, I love it. You do realize that on this carpet here, all the interviews that I've done for the past 26 years, Jeff Buckley, Bjork,
wow.
Flaming Lips, they've all stood on this, and now you're part of
that's
that
crazy.
History.
I love that.
You're working on a brand new music video now, right?
Yeah, it's actually two music videos, so it's
two?
It's like a mini like film, and it's for a song called Revolt, and then our new single called Let's Have a Wreck, so. It's a very like violent video. We're the last analog band, and we live in a world where it's all digital, and the police or whatever, they've found us and they've taken us hostage.
Now, did you record an analog or digital, seeing that you have a song?
We did do it to analog tape, and we played everything.
Everything's
completely
live.
All
the mistakes you hear are very, very real.
So you
real.
Did it the
very
old
real mistakes,
yeah. Yes. I mean, we're one of the few new bands that like come out and really know how to play an instrument, which is ridiculous.
No, I mean, like, it's crazy how many bands are like running tapes live now and use the auto tune, and we don't do that at all. What you see is what you get. Everything we're playing on stage is what we're really playing, and so all the rawness.
That
and
the sucks
mistakes
too. You know, when all the bands do that, it's like, where's the piano part?
Yeah.
It's here
I
somewhere.
I don't see a piano player and a string quartet up there on stage with you.
Drive A's in the studio. This is JBTV from downtown Chicago. Stay tuned. A lot more nonstop music on your alternative show from downtown Chicago.
Hey, we're Drive A, and you're watching JBTV.
David Costa Lives, our guest this week on JBTV. I want to go back to something Brad said about the sound. Where do you guys see yourself, David? Where do you see this band fitting in terms of sound or style? And I only mean that in a, like, in an iTunes format. Like, how do you describe this band?
It's tough, man.
Yeah?
I like to say that it's hip-hop, but it's more than hip-hop.
Right.
I like to say that we take a page out of enough books so that it doesn't really, it's not recognizable. Which books are you taking pages from? There's so many of them. It's definitely hip-hop. It'll always be that, because I can't sing. If I could sing, I'd probably never rap again. I'd just run with that singing thing. But since I can rap, it's always going to be rap, no matter what.
Right.
But I'd like to think with the live instrumentation in the studio and on stage that it kind of gives off a rock and roll feel,
yeah,
if you will.
So to come on JBTV is nonstop music as David Costa performs live. And later, Jenna and Nicole are on location with the Chicago Outfit Roller Derby team. It's all here next on JBTV.
David Costa lives, our guest this week on JBTV. I'm Ryan Mano. Talk a little bit about like the sequencing of that. I mean, hearing you describe the way you write songs, whether it takes a few years or if it, you know, it could just come out in a minute with Fig.
Sure.
It's like, I guess I just don't understand how a record could make that much sense being spread out over years or...
It's just like an autobiography. It's just like a journal. It's just like a journal I keep, but in song form. It rhymes. And that's okay. It. It's like I draw from...
So it's easy to put in order.
It's so easy. I mean, because it's real life events.
Right.
And so I'm just putting them in the order that they happened in real life. You know?
Yeah.
There's really no gimmick to it. It's just straight from my experience.
I think of it like that because I think of it not as real life. You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
Like, I think of it as art, and I'm like, God, this makes so much sense, but it's your life.
It's really, the Starving Artist is part two of a trilogy. There's going to be an album before this, and there's going to be an album after this. And the Starving Artist is the middle 5 years. It's basically a 15-year period broken down. And we're going to release the very first part of the story next, which would be the second release, and then the very third part, the end of the story, be released last. And so you'll be able to kind of pick up all three of the albums, listen to them in order, and it tells a beginning, middle, and end. So the Starving Artist is really the middle of this story.
Right.
If I could interject too, I've seen, basically what this guy does is he has like a pad of paper.
Yeah.
And he writes down everything. Like he documents everything in his life. And it might seem like it's not really, like it's just an autobiography, but, and hopefully I'm not giving too much away, but it seems to me like there's always a concept in mind and it's always, he's had this trilogy thing planned out before I started the band.
Right.
And he's been, it's all planned out.
It's always been a big picture of what David Costa wants to do. It's like a big criminal mastermind plan that he has, and we don't really know all the time where it's going. We don't even know. I mean, we might not do anything. The third album might just be about us being broke and homeless.
Still, honestly, nothing changed.
The third album,
still
the first album,
artist.
Definitely going to be about that.
Still
this
starving.
One's about it.
It'll be called Still Starving.
The third one could be about you know, boats and hoes, or it could be about...
Very hungry. Right. Please send food.
They'll stop burning the dollars food. And throw them on stage.
Right. Yeah. Please stop.
That's funny. Yeah.
It could be about anything. We never know.
We're living the third album right now. We're living it.
Cool.
You know, 4 years ago when we were writing, you know, the end of The Starving Artist, I wasn't able to say, doing interviews and, you know, I'm hanging out with ex artist and ex entertainer or whatever. And it's been fun, you know, but there's so much more to do, and I think that's why we're all getting really excited.
What's up, JBTV? What's happening? Millions of people just disappeared all over the planet. I'm seeing the crystal clear. People are panicking. I'm standing still like a mannequin. Looking around at how the population is handling it. Chaos, billions of day offs, canceled playoffs. Our religious leaders are scheduled all chaos. Riots, mass violence, ass science. How this is possible? Ambulance sirens, limited lootness. We got through this, but before you get your breath, check out how expensive the food is.
make some noise.
What is
there?
Oh,
hey, buddy.
Yeah.
You did have a bulletproof vest.
Oh yeah.
He's got a track.
Nice job, you're so great, man.
I love you guys.
Oh, we love you, man. I mean, if you want to invite us back once a month, we'll be here.
Absolutely. I mean,
if not, just to watch others, you know. Kyle will represent us.
I do.
He's been holding it down.
I come down here, you know, I hang out. If I had to be locked in one place, you know, some sort of apocalypse or something, here. I swear to God, is that okay? Here, we got enough footage in the background to hang out and listen to music and watch things for the rest of my life, pretty much. So, I'm pretty cool with that.
A lot more with Strung Out. Plus, we're taking you on location with the Chicago Outfit Roller Derby Team and some classic Disturbed. It's all here on JBTV next.
One of the best things I remember about working with you guys at the store were some. I guess it's not that awesome, but someone nearly got electrocuted to death in Spain.
That was me, but it was in Holland.
Oh, it was in Holland?
Yeah, it was in Holland.
Me
too.
And Chris got a secondary dose.
I was clean. Too.
I didn't have anything.
Yeah, so I was clean
with
that one.
How'd that go? I mean, they don't have ground wires there.
Something wasn't grounded right, and I was like soaking wet. I had one hand on my guitar, and I went and grabbed the mic to say something, and I just was frozen to it. You know, I was stuck to it. It threw me back into Chris, which broke the current and sent me flying into like the monitor board.
And you, as a result, also got electrocuted.
Yeah.
So,
yeah,
it's one of the, you know.
They took mic lessons after that. Yeah. Now they know how to work.
No, I never, yeah.
Wireless.
Really?
No. I just don't touch mics much. This is scaring me actually right now.
Yeah, don't worry. I think we got that one covered.
Thank you.
But that's pretty weird. You know, it would suck to die on stage, kind of.
It'd be kind of rad, actually.
Yeah.
I can see it in your eyes. I can hear it in your voice. The signs are obvious. We know we had us on its course. Why am I giving up the upper hand? And this is our shred. I spent too many nights on the floor. We bought something inside the sin. While I'm thinking anger, now it's all that you can see. Cause anger's all I got. Came the world by your way. Well, I know that this is nothing new. That's all I know. Just connect myself in your memory. I feel me being all to justify with all your words. Don't mean anything to me. Cause I've cut you and face each other, we've got nothing to say. A flashback to another time when silence was a world of fun. Sorry, I can never really say what is going on inside my head. Trying to justify special my war. Keep it.
See, that's a big rock ending right there.
Up next, the Chicago Outfit, Roller Derby Team, and David Costa Lives. Keep it tuned right here.
Going on? I'm Jenna Martinelli.
And I'm Nicole Marsel with JBTV.
We're hanging out. We are on the scene at Fleetwood Roller Rink. We're going to talk to the Chicago Outfit Derby Girls. They're Chicago's Derby Little Secret. Hanging out right now with Lola. She's part of the Chicago Outfit. How you doing?
Yeah, I'm good. How are you?
Good. Kind of tell me a little bit about the game and how it works.
Well, basically, there are two kind of different portions of the game. You have your blockers, you have your jammers. Your jammers are the point scorers. They're kind of like a human ball. Because a lot of people ask if there's a ball in roller derby, and there's not.
The best position to be is lead jammer.
Yeah.
In the jam, because they're the ones that can call off, and that's what this moment is all.
What does call off mean?
Calling off the jam, like, it gives you control of the game. So if the other jammer is way behind you, and you're scoring points, and you notice that they come up, you can call off the jam before they even get a chance to score 1 point.
So what do you do to get pumped up?
This season, we're doing a lot of, like, we're getting really zen and doing some group, like, visualizations.
Seriously, I'll just try and meditate.
Okay.
I like to listen to, like, music, and then Smashley, my partner in crime, she's also, like, the big hitter, so we just hit each other a lot.
Your name is Smashley, your name is Ashley, so you got it. What are some of the funkiest names that you've heard in Derby?
Well, one of our players is Kiefer Sutherland. That's pretty funny. Yeah, we have Susie Crotch Rot, too.
Oh, Crotch Rot, wow, okay.
Just years before I started, she just started calling me Gagan, because I'm gay.
Wait.
And my name is Megan.
Jenna and I will be out there with you guys later, so are we going to get, like, our butts handed to us? Or
we will be nice.
Because I don't think I've been on roller skates since I've been in, like, maybe fourth grade.
You're shorter and a lot smaller in size compared to some of the girls in the game.
I'm pretty hard to knock over because I have this low center of gravity.
Like squats?
Yeah, just like
squat. So it's good thing I did my leg workout today. What are the types of injuries that happen?
A lot of rink rash, rug burns.
Ooh, I can't even imagine.
There's no babying.
Yeah.
You have to take a hit. You have to, like.
For sure.
Yeah, so we'll see how tough you guys are.
Play nice. At least for the first 5 minutes.
We will.
Woo! Check it out!
Funny, I mean, you guys, you play hip hop shows, you open for Twista.
Twista.
Right?
Yes.
And then you playing with Papa Roach and you know, it's really just complete ends of the spectrum, unlike anything I've ever seen. You know, you could do a tour with 311 or Fish. I don't know. I mean, you guys could do anything. And it almost works to your advantage.
Yes.
The disadvantage of being able to define it almost as an advantage.
It's been an advantage that we have exploited, and we have been able to kind of play those different kinds of shows. You know, like you said, people are very, very adamant about you categorizing something for them.
And that's why I say, in an iTunes world, you've got to put
it in the hole. It's so tough, because, like I said, it's hip-hop. Like, we can't get away from that, because I'm rapping, but it's rock and roll, because it's got the live instruments, you know, and rock it out a little bit. You know, it's aggressive in nature, and so... it's got a few different vibes to it. We like to just let people judge for themselves, you know?
Mm.
And when they do that, it's like live band hip hop.
Put it back together and then tore it back apart. I apologize, how could I be so damn blind? You were mine, I knew this shit the whole damn time. You would find out, sooner or later I'd have to tell you. But how do you say, I know you're my destiny, but I failed you. So just exhale, do whatever you gotta do. But please don't forget that I love you, I know that you love me too.
But I'd like to think that maybe one day, people will be like, this new up-and-coming band, they sound like David Costa, what he does on stage with his band, hopefully one of these days, you know, we'll be considered innovators and, you know, actually original artists.
Right.
Like, I think most artists want to shoot for, they want to be considered original.
Where they have at least a sound, where you can hear a guitar tone or you can hear something and go, oh, that sounds like Blink-182,
sure.
Or that sounds like Green Day. Or
I hope,
you can, you know.
I hope we have our own sound. That's kind of, that was a goal.
Yeah, that was the main goal.
We always kind of want to make sure that we're not too hip-hop and not too rock. Otherwise, you kind of lose a lot of the crossover of, you know, we do have a lot of hip-hop bands, a lot of rock fans. You don't want to be too much of either.
All I ever wanted was just someone to live for. When she finally found me, there was nothing I did for. Now that I recognize that she was someone to die for, I committed suicide and hung myself. I hung myself.
Yo. Still to come on JBTV, Strung Out performs live, and we're going way back with a classic interview with David and Disturbed. It's all here next. So you're from Chicago, right?
Right.
And you've never seen our show?
I've seen your show.
Oh, good.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, good. I thought you didn't know anything about our show.
I knew about your show. I have much respect for JBTV.
Now, isn't there something about when you get on the stage, something happens when you're there?
There's nothing in the world like it. If I could draw a comparison, sex, okay, is energy transfer between two people, one person on one person, most of the time. Playing is energy transfer between, let's say, one person or four people in a band and 1,000 or 5,000 or 7,000. It's that much more intense. And you have all that energy being channeled into you.
Mm-hmm.
And it's unbelievably intoxicating. That is the only thing in my life that this is about. I need it. I need it like I need air or water or anything else. And if I don't let the monster out to play every once in a while on that stage and get him to feed off of some of that energy, I don't know where I would be.
So you've got two of these babies in there, huh?
Oh, yeah. Had them both done at the same time, which is probably not the smartest thing in the world. But I didn't want to look all stupid with just one coming out of the side of my chin.
Uh-huh.
Like they did this one. After this.
Uh-huh.
This one didn't hurt. This one hurt like a bitch.
Wow.
Because the whole area was just already awake. We had a lot of questions from female fans who obviously wonder if it hurts. And I guess most of them find out that it really doesn't.
It's more pleasure to them.
That's what I've been told. So.
Uh-huh. Now, what is the absolute sickness? Is it like a disease or,
no,
or a virus or a...
no, it's nothing like that. It's a philosophy that is all about individuality and development of self and just living life with passion. And when you do that, when you kind of stand out from the rest of the sheep, so to speak, and you kind of become blacklisted, people think there's something wrong with you, that you're sick, that you're twisted, that you're disturbed. Anything that will spread the sickness to the rest of the world is what we're all about.
Well, it's been a pleasure having you here.
Cool.
And you're always welcome.
Thank you.
And next time, hopefully another video and everything, you know. And
God willing.
Yeah.
And Toby, it was great for you doing the interview. Thank you. It was good to see you.
Oh, you guys are the best.
I miss you, man.
I've known these jokers for too long, and I'm surprised they still speak to me. But, you know, I saw him outside. I was walking to JBTV, and I hear, like, Toby? And I go, oh, not my public again. But I turned it. It was this handsome devil.
I'll always find myself in this little blind. See, it's been a few weeks since you've been around here. I set my head shut down, patiently await a secret. Bravely is the plan out. But here I sit, I'm tied up all alone with all my thoughts. I do not mind if this goes on.
getting old. I'm the hell I got this way, but I'm not much more I take. A million ways to shame myself, but it's not right. But here I sit, I'm tired of all alone with all my thoughts. When I learn to walk away from the things I didn't make me feel the way I feel when I'm with you, and I didn't see myself enough. Come around and do the things you do to me. It just came up so
it's nonstop JBTV. David Costa lives. He's performing live right here on JBTV next. JBTV is brought to you in part by Rock Razor Scissors, Do312.com, and Emperor Cabs. JBTV!
It's JBTV, Ryan Mano with David Costa lives. I want to talk a little bit about the message, the meaning, some of the lyrics, the content. In particular, Wars and Rumors of Wars.
Okay.
That's, I guess, would you say that that's sort of been like the single or the standout track or
that's
the favorite?
That's our anthem.
Is that, yeah?
It is kind of like the anthem.
Didn't people start burning money at the Twista show?
I no comment.
Okay.
I plead the fifth on that
no,
one.
That's fine.
We don't ask them to do that.
Yeah, I mean, the song was just kind of supposed to, you have to understand the context of where that song comes from in the middle of the story. Because I want to bring people together with what we agree on. Mm-hmm. And we agree on that, like, you know, we kind of want the money in our pocket to be worth something. And we want to be able to spend that and get the right value out of it. And I think that the statistic is that as of 1913, the American dollar at that time was worth a dollar. Right now is worth 4 cents. So really, I think the message in Wars and Rumors of Wars is you're not even really burning a dollar. You're burning 4 pennies that you wouldn't bend over on the street to pick up. And it's making a statement, and it's kind of, and I personally, it's weird to say that I've never burnt a dollar in my life. Mm-hmm. I've never taken fire to a dollar bill and caught it on fire and held it up in the air for everyone to see. I never did that. But yet, I get a kick out of it every single time we play a show. There's a few people do it. I'm like, that's just fantastic. You know?
Yeah.
It is. It's like burning a draft card, making a statement.
Right.
I guess.
And a bra.
It upsets some people. Some people are like, it's good to see the reactions because like some people are like, that's just the stupidest thing I've ever seen in my life.
Right.
Why would you do that?
Yeah. I've seen people pick them up off the ground, taping half dollars together that are burned.
I've had two halves at home
that you never know how desperate I get. Yeah, I might need them.
People come up to me after the show like, here, they give me the end of it. Like it's a souvenir for me or something. Mm-hmm. It's cool. It's a cool experience. I don't.
Well, if anything, it means that what you are saying, what you've written, what you've thought about, and what you're, as a band, putting out there is having some sort of impact, you know, that's pushing someone to do something physical.
I'd like to think that half the people get it, and the other half the people just think, hey, I'm a rebel.
Right.
Just do it to be rebellious.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but I think some people are doing it because they're like, you're right, you know. We want to draw attention to this issue this really, 4 cents, I'll burn that. Why not?
Let's see it. Wars and Rumors of Wars. David Costa lives, performing it live on our JBTV HD soundstage.
If you got a dollar in your pocket, hold it up like this. Next year, that dollar's worth 89 cents. The test here is how to make your bank account stretch to the best of your ability, your real TD press by hand. Almost anyone can do the math. That's why you see the market about to crash. Ask, what is going on? I'm not a terrorist. Just because I talk about the way things are unfair, I guess. Let's dig a little deeper while we can. Demand cannot exceed the supply that they have. And the market has an invisible hand. It's not your toy to play with, understand? They created this so that only a few are rich. The rest of us slave for wages. Get taxed to deal with inflation. It's outrageous. Most of the people blind out of cages.
really sick to death. We don't respond or respect the person that represents our best interests and intellect.
Yet instead,
pick someone trying to claim our interest
off of our debt.
So what you get is what you expect. We're sleeping people, leading evil into our homes, making our privacy reveal
its closing doors,
making our love consider something concealed.
The taste is bitter,
but I'm still ready to re-steal
and rebuild our free will. And I will
promise always to protect
till I die in breath,
cause I'm a beast of the neglect. Into this bad dream, so I'm stuck battling people
that can't see.
See that brought me my instincts and put me back on my feet. Alone with this weed and a microphone as a link. Eat together the gaps between the death and the beast that were once awake but fell back to sleep.
If you got a dollar in your pocket, hold it up like this. Turn it to a crisp, cause it ain't worth shit. Dollar in my pocket, hold it up like this. Turn it to a crisp, turn it to a crisp.
If you got a dollar in your pocket, hold it up like this.
Burn it to a crisp, cause it ain't worth shit.
You got a dollar, I'm going up like this.
Burn it to a crisp, burn it to a crisp.
I am sick and tired of being sick of this world that I'm living in, so much sick of the syphilis. If the significance of these particular incidents indicates where we're headed, possibilities are infinite. If it gets any cheaper than wars, then rumors of wars, then there's a definite development after this freaking hazardous. We're living in times that have been predicted. Freedoms have been restricted. Privileges have been lifted. We've shifted from where we were